the word you hear that cleanses your mind. When your mind has been cleansed, your life is holy. If you are not taught who Christ is, you cannot live an effective Christian life. There is no other honor greater than that of sonship. Worldliness is the trap that enslaves men to the devil.
Relationship with God is a gift. Fellowship is a choice. The true expression of divine love is forgiveness to others. What you pursue is an expression of what you desire.
Know this, that in the last days, perilous times will come. For men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, and from such people turn away. In the last days, part one. Now let me give you our focus for part one. Isaiah chapter 2, verse 2 and 3. It shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. So in the last days, part one is the rising of the glorious church. Hallelujah. So we are in the last days, and we want to see what happens in the last days. Glory be to God. And say, Father, open my heart to your word. Open my heart to your word. Open my heart to your word. In the name of Jesus. So the scripture says, in the last days, perilous times shall come. Men shall be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God. So we already know that kind of part, but I want to take it from a different angle this morning and show us that there is another aspect of the last days that we must emphasize upon. In the last days as well, it has been prophesied that the glorious church will rise. Glory be to God. Let me begin by saying this, that the Bible says in Joel chapter 2 verse 17, it shall come to pass on the last days, I shall pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions. So on the last day, God is pouring out the spirit so we can prophesy. Now, the presence of the prophetic anointing in the church is to enable the saints to interpret the signs of the times. The presence of the prophetic anointing in the church is to enable the saints to do what? To interpret the signs of the time. Because to everything, there is a time. To every activity, there is a season. So, unless we can interpret the time, we don't know what you're supposed to do now. And if you don't know what you have to do now, you'll be a victim of the wickedness of the devil that is going through now. So, there is a certain way we have to behave by the understanding of the times. Glory be to God. So, as long as you are a Christian, there is a prophetic anointing upon you in this time. Now, that anointing, as I said, is not to be able to call the names of people. No. The prophetic anointing will open your eye to be able to interpret the signs of the time. So, you can know how you ought to behave in a particular season. Because we are in the last days. Now, when we focus on the last days, most often, there is a tendency to focus on what the devil is doing, evil, trouble, sickness. But I want to show you that in the last days, it has been prophesied that the church will have dominion over the world. It says, it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be exalted, lifted above other mountains. Which means, according to prophecy, In the last days, the church is supposed to have dominion over the systems of the world, not the world having dominion over the church. Are you following me, child of God? So now the church is you and I. It's not like a building, it's us. Bible has given this prophecy that in these times we're supposed to take over. And I pray for us that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we shall take over in the name of Jesus. Amen. I said we will take over in the name of Jesus. Amen. So the Bible specifies, it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be exalted above other other mountains, and all nations shall flow to it. It's prophecy. So, if you are too focused on what the devil is doing, you will be hindered from fulfilling your own responsibility in these days. If you are too focused on how many people the devil is killing, what is happening here? We must be more focused on what the Holy Spirit is doing, not what the devil is doing. Can I tell you something? Every work of the devil is a distraction to take the heart of men away from the work of God. So every time the devil begins to operate, never forget that his purpose is to distract us, not to focus on God so we can focus on him. Because one thing the devil wants is that we should focus on him. If you focus on the devil, you cannot experience your God. So the devil will bring up things so we can focus on him. But child of God, don't put your focus on the devil. Put your focus on the Holy Spirit. Put your focus on your God. Put your focus on the God that you serve. So the devil comes and begins to operate. Now, many Christians who are, listen to me, when Christians are ignorant about God's mind for a season, they cannot enjoy the release of the Spirit in that time. In every season, there is a particular release of an anointing. Until you understand what God wants to do in that time, you cannot be part of that move. You cannot be part of that blessing. You cannot be part of that end time movement. And I want to assure you that in this time, God has a plan for every one of us. Every one of us have to be part of that agenda. There is something great that God is doing, and God expects you and I to be part of it. The rising of the glorious church. Say, the glorious church is rising. One more time again. The glorious church is rising. Say, the glorious church is rising. So, there is something the devil is doing. But there is something God is doing. And when you put all of your attention on the devil, he will hinder you from seeing what God is doing. I want you, as you leave this place this morning, to take back your focus from the well and put it on the Lord. Don't forget what I said. The purpose of the works of the devil is to take our eyes off the work of the Lord and focus on him. No, you have to be wiser than that. Right now, all people do every day is to be checking the things that are happening. Stop checking what the devil is doing. Start checking what God is doing. What is God doing? What are you doing? Because we Christians, we are becoming so focused on what the devil is doing that we ourselves, we are not doing what we have to do. In the last days, everybody has a role to play. There is something the devil is doing. There is something the saints must do. There is a prophecy on our head that we must fulfill. So while the devil is fulfilling his own part of the prophecy, as Christians, we ought to give diligence to fulfill our own part of the prophecy. The devil comes not but to steal, to kill, and destroy. But Jesus has come that we may have life. Now Jesus is moving in the world through us. So our understanding should make us know that in the times like this, you have a role to play. Not to sit down and be sharing news of how the devil is killing people. You have to share the gospel. You have to share the good news. You have to be the light, because there's a prophecy on your head. No matter the amount of darkness that is operating, darkness cannot quench light. We are the light of the world. The church is the light of the world. The Bible has given the clear word that in the last days, lift your hands and say, Lord, open my eye to know who I am. Open my eye to know who I am. In the name of Jesus. That's our focus for today. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, help me. I have a role to play. I have something I must do. Don't be lost in this time. Don't be lost in this season. The kingdom needs you. Are you listening to me, child of God? Listen, in the last days, your preservation and your prosperity depends on your availability to kingdom agenda. Your preservation and prosperity depends on your availability to fulfill kingdom purpose. In other words, how much preservation you will enjoy from God depends on how available you are to fulfill the end time agenda, God's plan for this time. This is not time to be joking. He said, in the last days, men shall be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, lovers of pleasure. The church should not be among those people. We should be lovers of God, not lovers of pleasure, not lovers of money, not lovers of ourselves. So there is a particular character that the church must demonstrate in these last days. Is a character of unconditional love for God. Our love for God should not be because of what we expect from Him. It should be because we know that He gave His Son for us. Because if your love for God is tied to your expectations, when they don't manifest, you will not love Him anymore. But if your love for God is tied to your understanding of the sacrifice of Christ, then it's unconditional. Are you with me, child of God? So the Bible says, therefore, in the last day, I shall pour my spirit upon all flesh. So we see, number one, for the glorious church to rise, number one, there is an outpour of the spirit. Let us see Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2, verse 17 to 21. And it shall come to pass in the last days, said God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall see dreams. Let's read it again. It shall come to pass in the last days, said God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. So, in the last days, there is not only the release of plagues and sickness, there is a release of the spirit. That's what I want you to focus on. Oh, sickness has come. People are dying. Yes, sickness had to come. But Jesus said in the last days, these things will come. But there is, listen to me, if you are too focused on what the devil is doing, you will miss what God has planned for you. There is the spirit that is released upon us. God says in the last days, there will be an outpour of the spirit upon his sons and daughters, and they shall prophesy, they shall see visions. There is an empowerment from heaven for the church to rise by the Holy Spirit. So this makes me understand that as a Christian, it is impossible to fulfill your destiny if you neglect fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Because in the last days, the first thing God does is that for the church to rise, there's an outpour of the Spirit. There's a release of the anointing. It is time for you to focus on what God is doing. There's an anointing in the atmosphere that if you can make yourself available, if that anointing comes upon you, you become a weapon in the hands of God to turn this world back to Himself. Because no matter how darkness will be rising, light will also be shining. He said, you are the light of the world. Let your light so shine that men will see and glorify your Father in heaven. The light shines in darkness, and darkness does not understand. So in the last days, there's an outpour of the anointing of God. Are you not seeing miracles happening? You think they're happening by what? It's by the anointing. You just said the sister just testified now. Her sister had breast cancer. And I prophesied. Laid hands on the picture. Breast cancer left her. Her sister was diagnosed with coronavirus. I prayed. 2 days later, they said she was healed in the hospital. Doctors don't understand. Why? Because I have come to understand I must focus on the anointing on me, because something that is on me has the ability to stop what the devil is doing. There is an anointing on your head. Amen. No matter what is happening now in the
the world.
The church is a solution. You are the light of the world, which means in the absence of the church, the world shall be engulfed in darkness. It is the presence of the church that is hindering darkness from consuming the world.
You don't know who you are in the eyes of God. You don't know.
You are too important. There are some things that cannot happen in your neighborhood because you are there. Because darkness is afraid of light. Darkness is afraid of light. That anointing is an empowerment. We do not complain with the world. Friends, when the world complains, they have right to complain because they have no solution. We don't complain. We have the Spirit of God. We have the anointing of the Most High God. That anointing by which God can be ushered into the atmosphere. Child of God. It is the Holy Spirit that brings the reality of heaven and the experience of divinity on earth. So when it says, I shall pour out my spirit, it means I shall empower men to walk in the reality of heaven. Friend, we are not like others. The anointing of God is upon us. When you hear that I prayed for picture and somebody was healed of cancer, this thing God is doing, it is a sign. It's not about caving. God wants to show all of you that this is what happens when a person is submitted to the Holy Spirit. It becomes a channel for signs, wonders, and miracles. In the last days, I shall pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Friend, you are too valuable to God. The anointing is upon your life. So, when darkness begins to operate, the church must understand that darkness is an opportunity for the light to prove its sovereignty. You hear what I said? The appearance of darkness is an opportunity for light to prove its sovereignty. For light to prove that it is stronger, darkness must come. So don't be afraid. Don't be moved. No matter the darkness that is happening, we shall solve it. That is why we should all give ourselves to prayer. Praying for 5 minutes in your house, things are happening. Are you following me here? When the saints neglect prayer, that is when the devil can take. If as long as we stand here, we pray, nothing happen. So number one, what does God do? The release of what? The Spirit. The release of what? The release of what? The release of what? The Spirit. That brings you that. Oh, the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Lord said, I will not leave you as orphans. The appearance of darkness is an opportunity for light to prove its sovereignty. For light to demonstrate its sovereignty. That you are bigger. So there are certain things God will permit to happen so that light can shine forth. Yes, that's what happens. Focus on what God is doing, not what the devil. The devil is here. The devil is there. But the Holy Spirit is also there. And this is the issue. The spiritual force that attracts your attention is what will determine your experience on the earth. If the devil succeeds to attract your attention, I'm telling you, your life will be fear. But if God attracts your attention, you'll be a life of faith, signs, and wonders. What is taking your attention? Take your attention. If you put your heart, I'm telling you, on what is happening, before you know, fear will finish you. There is nobody who has not felt like they have coronavirus. Why they cough so? I said, no, but I never forget them. I'm under grace. It cannot happen to me. Blood of Jesus. No, wait. I just text my papa. Just pray for me. I'm feeling my chest tight. You know what's happening to you? That's fear. And where did the fear come from? Because you have been hearing news. But now, if your focus was to be hearing news about the operation of the Holy Spirit, you bring faith in God. But when your focus is hearing news about the operation of evil spirit, you will bring fear. And whatever you fear, you will attract. Job said, the things I fear have happened to me. So So fear will open the door for things to happen to you. So what do I do? My focus is the Holy Spirit. Oh, there is a devil. I will say, yes, there's the Holy Spirit also. So if the world, listen to me, the Bible, Jesus said in John 14, he said, I will give you the Holy Spirit, whom the world cannot see and cannot know. So it is impossible for the world to discern the presence of the Holy Spirit unless the saints rise up and begin to manifest. The only way the world can know that the Holy Ghost is here is when somebody is diagnosed of breast cancer and we pray and they are healed, and the doctors get confused and they keep doing more tests. If something is happening that they don't comprehend it, which power did this? That is when we can tell them, come, there is a God. I've had several doctors that have received Christ after miracles happen. A woman was operated and her womb taken out. Then she came with prayer and she got pregnant, and the doctor had to call me and say, I want to receive Jesus. Because you can't explain. There is an anointing, the power of the Holy Spirit. And the greatest thing is this, that power is not on prophets. I shall pour my spirit upon all flesh. All. Every Christian, by reason of the presence of the Holy Spirit, has been empowered to walk in signs, wonders, and miracles. I shall pour my spirit upon all flesh. So I can't be given to fear because my focus is on the work of the Holy Spirit. Oh, this is happening here. Yes, I know. The Holy Ghost is also happening here. It's happening also. It's not only Satan. The Holy Ghost is working. He's doing things. He's healing the sick, raising the dead. Just that the way the system of the world is orchestrated, even when God operates, they will always try their best to silence it. But you cannot silence light for too long. No matter how they try to hide the resurrection of Christ, it was still known public because there was an anointing that rose him from the dead. He says, and Pilate, they put people to stand at the tomb. They put a stone there, but angels came, removed the stone, and it still came out. You cannot prevent the rising of the church. It has been prophesied that in the last days, the church shall be established upon the mountain. No government, no devil, no antichrist. The church is rising. They can do nothing. Nothing can happen. The saints are taking over. You can do nothing. Listen to me. Until the church manifests the dominion of Christ on the world, the antichrist cannot reign. So all what they are doing, they are wasting their time. It will fail. Because we have to reign first. It is scriptural. The antichrist is not permitted to operate as long as the church is still here. It is only after rapture that the antichrist will operate. So he is acting a film. It has failed already. It has failed big time. With their sickness, it will pass very soon. Because all this is an agenda. All this sickness is antichrist's agenda. It's a system to introduce the dominion of the antichrist. It has failed. It has failed. Nothing can happen because the church is here. It has been prophesied in the last days. It shall come to pass that the mountain of the Lord shall be exalted above all the mountains, and all nations will flow to it. Ha! Unto all nations flow to the house of God, the end cannot come. Yes, it is scripture. It means what? There is an impact. Listen to me, you see all of you here. You are going to be shocked. It's not like you pray too much. It's just because it is time. You are going to be operating in a strange dimension of grace. You know what? Wait, you know why God is doing that? It's because he wants the well to flow to the church. So, saints are going to prosper. Bible says, the more they afflicted them, they multiplied. They said, these people doing? Then they will come now. And we'll convert them to our God. That's how he has to operate. Number two, that God does for the glory of the church to rise is the release of the word of God. Let's see Isaiah chapter 2, verse 3. Okay, let's leave on verse 2. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. Verse 3. Yeah. And many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, and he will teach us his ways, and we will walk in his path. For out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. So number two, for the glorious church to rise, there must be the release of the word of God. Listen to me. The dominion of the church over the systems of the world shall be on the wings of the Spirit and the word of God. Two things. If you are anointed and you are not full of the word, you will not take over in this season. If you are also full of the word and not anointed, not take over. You need this. There are two wings. This is the wings of the eagle. The wings of the eagle. The wing of the anointing and the wing of the word of God. The release of the word. He said, let us go to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways. So God is saying that for the glorious church to rise, after he has released the spirit, the focus of the saints must be the word of God, not miracles. Because when the word of God is magnified, the spirit, God is glorified. Miracles happen with that problem. Are you with me, child of God? So every Christian in this our time, number one, focus on the anointing. Number two, focus on the word of God. Focus on the word of God. Focus on the word. Because this is what is now. I said the dominion of the church over the systems of the world shall be on the wings of the anointing and the word. For the church to take over, for the saints to have dominion, to have power over this system, over this world. Friends, the word of God. The word of God. The word of God. The word of God. It is time to commit yourself to the word. It is time for, he said, I shall give these people pastors after my heart who will feed the sheep with knowledge and understanding. And it shall come to pass after that they shall multiply. They will feed the sheep with what? With what and what? Why? Because I said, which are the two wings? Don't forget this. If you must fly, you need the wings of the anointing and the wings of the word. These are the two wings you need to fly as an eagle in this end time. They that wait upon the Lord shall mantle wings like, and they shall fly. Eagle has how many wings? Two. One is what? The anointing. The other one, the word of God. So that dominion of the church over the systems of this world shall be through the wings of the anointing and of the word. Write that down. Your dominion, the dominion of the church, Isha, these are the two things that we must focus on in this time. That is what we need to move, to take over, to force the systems of this world to submit to our God. The word of the Lord must go forth. And they that know their God shall be what? Strong. And shall do exploits. Now, if you read that scripture, Daniel 12, 32, it was speaking of when the Antichrist has to come. He said when the Antichrist will come, he will do wickedly against the covenant. But they that know their God. So in the midst of the reign of the system of the Antichrist, those that know their God shall overcome their tricks. So what you need to focus on the word of God. Friend, commit yourself to knowing God. As we preach, go home, open the Bible, read it. Commit yourself. You must know God. Because you are part of God's plan in this end time. God wants to use you to save your family. But God needs you to be full of the anointing and the word. It needs you to have a balance of these two things. So when you begin to operate, the devil cannot suppress you. The devil cannot afflict you. Because you are balanced by the wings of the word and the wings of the anointing. Are you following me, child of God? He says, the they shall come to the house of the Lord, and he will teach them his ways. See what they teach in the church? His ways. Not he will teach them how to get married. Bible says, in the last days, men shall be lovers of money. It means when they come to church, they only want to hear the things that bring money. They shall be lovers of pleasure. They don't want to hear about cars and visa. But if they were lovers of God, they want to go for the knowledge of God. So as a Christian, the spirit of the Antichrist operating now is drawing men to the devil by their desire for the things of the world. Be careful. Your desire must be for your God. Your desire must be for heaven. Your desire must be for the things above. Will you have these things on the earth? Of course, yes. But your focus is not them. Your focus is to know God. Because only they that know their God shall be strong. In the midst of every wickedness, every demonic attack, if you don't know God, you will fall. If you don't know God, you will fail. Listen to me. I have not changed my message. This is what I've been preaching for the past 7 years. I've been preaching since repent, be holy, be righteous. That's what I've been preaching. Because I was preparing you for such a time as this. Because they that know their God shall be strong. It is time for you to say, I must focus. Friends, in this particular time, your sustenance on this earth realm depends on your knowledge of God and who you are in Him. I'm telling you. It's no longer much about your pastor. You have to know God. Yes, you have to know Him. You have to know God. Because the Antichrist is operating everywhere now. Their system is being put in place to oppress Christians. And Bible has specified, only those who know their God shall be strong. So, if the glorious church, if the church does not focus on teaching the saints the knowledge of God, it cannot rise as a glorious church. Are you following me, child of God? The release of the word of God. The release of the word of God. He shall teach us his ways. Number three, for the glorious church to rise, there must be holiness. Let us see Ephesians chapter 5, verse 26. That he might sanctify her, talking about the church, and cleanse her with the washing of water by the word. Verse 27. That he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy without blemish. You see, number three, if she should be a glorious church, she must be holy. She must be holy. She must be holy. She must be holy. When the devil wants to hinder the saints from taking over and having dominion in this world, the devil corrupts them with sin. Friend, sin is an enemy. There are certain things that you have to stop doing, but you must stop them, because I'm telling you, your life depends on it. The things that you used to do, nothing happened. You can do them now and you die very fast. Because Bible says in the last days, the devil knows that his time is short. So he begins to walk very fast. He will start killing people very, very fast. Any mistake, bam, he kills you fast, so you don't have time to repent. So you should be careful of sin. But even if it does not kill you, as long as sin is still present in the church, it will be a hindrance from the church rising as a glorious church. We must understand that sin is our enemy. The devil is not our enemy. Sin is our enemy. For there to be the rising of the glorious church, people of God, we must be understand the power and the value of holiness. 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 What is holiness? Holiness is consecration, separation from the world, and dedication to the Lord. To be holy means I don't behave like the world. That is holiness. I don't behave like the world. I behave like God. God is holy. He wants his people to be holy. When you are walking in unforgiveness, you are unholy, because God forgives. Every time you do something that is against the character of God is an expression of unholiness. Because holiness is godliness. Holiness means being like God. So, if you want to act in this end time, I'm telling you the truth. That little unforgiveness in your heart can be the reason why you will not see God in this time. Do away with it. Do away with fornication. Do away with immorality. Keep those. Listen to me. Times are too dangerous. Stop joking with your life. Don't joke with your destiny. The devil is out to kill more than before. I'm telling you. We know he kills, but now the way he wants to kill is not like before. Stop those kind of lifestyle. You have to be holy for you to take your place in this end time agenda. To present himself a holy church. You can't still be there. My friend, take your life serious. The kingdom needs you. Take your destiny serious. The kingdom of God needs you in a time like this. It says Christ is washing the church to make her holy so she can be presented as a glorious church without spot or blemish. Holiness. Holiness. He said, so Romans 12 verse 1, present your body as a living sacrifice, holy and blameless, for this is your acceptable service. Child of God, any service not rendered on the platform of holiness cannot attract the attention of God. So it's not important. My focus is not to come to preach. You know, if I am preaching to you now, no matter what I'm preaching, if I am unholy, what I'm doing now, God does not see it now. Without holiness, no one shall see God. But Hebrews 12:15, he said, without holiness, no one shall see God. Holiness is living by the standard of the Lord. Worldliness is living by the standard of the world. So, be careful. Romans 12 verse 2. He said, brothers and sisters, I love you so much. He said, be not conformed to this world. What is the meaning? He was talking to Christians. Because in the last days, when the antichrist system begins to operate, their purpose is to make Christians conform to them. Friends, don't dress like them. The time has come. We shall put ushers at the gate. If by mistake you have a dress, they see your breast, either will give you rabbi, you cover, or you go and change and come back. Not because we are afraid to be tempted. Temptation has not disturbed us. But because we want your soul to be saved. We refuse that you should be an instrument in the hands of Satan. So don't say, I did not know. Now you know. Because do not dress like them. Do not talk like them. Friend, no matter how God is merciful, God will not bring down his standard for any man. The standard of God remains holiness. The mercy of God is God being compassionate to you so that you can come into his standard. God does not bring himself down to sin. It's a lie. If God shows you mercy, it's because he wants grace to lift you into holiness. Sin shall not have dominion over you, for you are not under the law. You are under grace. I refuse to be a slave to sin. I refuse to be a slave to anger. I refuse to be a slave to pride. I refuse to be a slave to immorality. I refuse. That is why we began with the Holy Spirit. The Pope, listen to me, one of the assignments of the Holy Spirit in the life of a Christian is to convict his heart of sin so he can repent. Every time you do something which is wrong, the Holy Ghost will make you feel this thing is wrong. And we say, the way you spoke to this person is wrong. Ah, forgive me. Friend, if you harden your heart to the Holy Spirit, you have opened your heart to the devil. That's why you need to have a living conscience. A living conscience is a conscience that responds to the voice and the leadings of the Holy Spirit. That if you perceive that is wrong, you quickly say, Lord, I'm sorry. Because in the last days, if there's something you must do, oh boy, your gun garment must be white. Revelation 14, I believe from verse 7 or verse 14, he said, from verse 7, he said, these are the people who have made their garment white by washing it in the blood of the Lamb. They came out of the tribulation because of holiness. No matter what the devil is doing, I'm telling you, the devil cannot touch a holy person. He cannot. Because holiness is a fire. Bible says when God came down on the mountain, Moses saw the glory, but the people saw the fire. Moses was holy, he saw the glory. The people were unholy, they saw fire. In other words, when you walk in holiness, your spiritual environment is saturated with the consuming fire of heaven. No sickness. Listen to me. The cure, the vaccine against Satan, sickness, anything is holiness. If you are holy, it cannot work. That's a true vaccine. As long, what are they injecting? As long as the world is still in sin, more sicknesses will come. If you sanitize your hand and you don't sanitize your heart, you still be a victim of Satan tomorrow. Because he will just devise another means and still come back and catch up you again. Because as long as you are in sin, you are a slave to the devil. Shall you be free today? Shall you be free today? How can you do it? Love holiness. Love God. Choose to be holy. Fight on holiness. Refuse sin. Reject it with all your heart. It is wrong. I reject to be in sin. Rise up from the valley of sin. Rise up from the valley of immorality. Listen to me. You can come out if you choose to. After the death of Christ on the cross, whoever abides in sin does so by choice and not by force. As long as Jesus died on the cross, he has broken the power of sin. But he has not taken away your choice to choose sin. So if you are still in sin, it's not because sin is so strong. It's because you still find pleasure there. The pleasures of the flesh. Rise up. If Christians get offended when we tell them to dress well, there's a problem. If Christians get offended when we tell them, forgive your neighbor, there's a problem. This thing should be a natural thing for Christians. We should not be taught how to dress. We are the ones who teach the world how to dress, not the church teach us how to dress. The church should not teach us how to behave. We are the ones that know God. And by reason of our knowledge of God, we're supposed to be a reflection. We are, listen, now on this earth realm, man is not longer in the image of God. I can prove it to you. The Bible says God made man in his image and likeness. In Genesis chapter 5 verse 1, he said, and God made Adam in his image and likeness. He said, and Adam sinned, and Adam had a child in his own image, no longer in the image of God. In this earth realm now, it is the church that has the image and likeness of God, no longer men. So men, he said, Philip, if you have seen me, you have seen the Father. So God says, you my people, you people are the one to teach the world how to behave. Teach them how to love. You, in your family, you are the one to demonstrate the character of holiness, the character of love, the character of forgiveness, the character of reconciliation. You, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. We can't be the one gossiping. We can't be the one bringing quarrel. No. The glorious church will not rise until we have value for holiness. Value for holiness. Are you following me, child of God? Number four. For the glorious church to rise, the saints must give themselves to prayer. Let us see Isaiah 56 verse 7. Even then, I will bring to my holy mountain and make them what? Joyful in my house of prayer. In my house of what? In my house of what? In my house of their burnt offering and their sacrifice will be accepted on my altar. For my house shall be called a house of prayer for all nations. You see why we are important. The anointing, the word, holiness, prayer. The last thing I want to bring to you, there are more, but we'll end here. For the glorious church to rise in the last day, the saints must give themselves to prayer. Do you know why? The expansion of the kingdom of Satan on this earth is only possible when the saints don't give themselves to prayer. If we pray, their plans will fail. It's time to pray. In your own corner, pray. Pray for yourself. Above all, pray for the church of God. Let us stop selfish prayer. I'm telling you, not pray for yourself. Lord, give me. Lord, raise the church. Because if the church rises, all will not stand up. True. It's time to pray. My house, it shall not be called the house of prayer for yourself. The prayer for all nations. The divinely ordained weapon for intercession to take over. Friend, we have to pray. Prayer, listen, as Christians, we don't pray because we want to pray. We pray because we have to pray. It's not like I don't feel like praying. Satan is not a feeling, no. He will finish you. The antichrist is moving. The devil is moving. Looking for whom to devour. Pray, 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 pray. They said, Daniel, don't pray for 30 days. If you pray, we'll give it to the lion. Daniel understood. That time, the demonic prince of peace, Persia, was about to bring a kind of demonic system over the world at that time. And he wanted to bring it through that kingdom, Persia, in Babylon, to bring in a demonic system and to oppress the Jews. But the only thing that was disturbing that demon from doing that thing was the prayer of Daniel. So because the prince of Persia was scared of the prayer of Daniel, he went and made some people to make a law that nobody should pray. He says for 30 days, everybody should pray only to the prince of Persia. Daniel understood. Daniel said, no, I'll pray. Better I pray and I die, because I know that my blood has been used to stop the advancement of Satan's kingdom. That was the reason. The reason was because Daniel's prayer had a spiritual effect. Friends, prayer is the only means to involve God into the affairs of this world. Unless the saints pray, no matter what is happening, God does not act. We have to pray. We have to pray. Let them say what? Friends, give yourself to prayer. If you are praying 5 minutes, start praying 10 minutes. If you pray 10, pray 15. But give yourself to prayer. Give yourself to prayer. Pray for yourself. Pray for your family. Pray for the church. Pray for men of God. Pray. I'm telling you, because I'm telling you, in this end time, mark my word, I speak this as a prophet. They are angels of God who are going about, and the assignment is to notice people who are giving themselves to prayer for the kingdom of God. These men and women shall be greatly rewarded at the coming of Christ. Pray. Pray. Don't be overcome. Pray. Pray. We are the solution. The Bible says in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 7 to 8, it says, the Antichrist cannot come because he that is, there's somebody hindering him. It is us. It's the Holy Spirit through our prayer. You have to pray. If we must rise as the glorious church, then the house of God must no longer be a place for buying and selling. It must be a house of prayer. Bible says, and Jesus entered the temple and he saw the people buying and selling, and he took a whip. What did he say? It is written, my house shall be called the house of prayer, but you have turned it into a den of thieves. Hi, when the house of God becomes the hiding place of armed robbers, it's only because prayer is absent. The Bible says in Acts chapter 28, it says, when Paul came on a certain island called Malta, he said, they were trying to make fire because they were feeling cold. It was cold there. While they were trying to make the fire, Bible says, as Paul was gathering firewood, he said, a viper was driven out by the heat of the fire. Now, we know that viper speaks of Satan, who is the devil, true of us. As long as the place was cold, the serpent was hiding and operating. He said, but when the fire came, the serpent was driven by the heat of the fire. Now, we all know that fire is symbolic of the anointing generated by prayer. God said, let the light on the altar not go off. We mean pray all the time. In the Old Testament, when you light the candles, they put candles in the temple. God said, those candles should never be off. So the work of the priest was always to come and be filling oil in the lamp so that it should not go off. Now, spiritually, it was meaning that the priest, the people have to always be praying so that the lamp should not go off. So when the saints pray, they make their environment uncomfortable for the devil to operate there. We have to pray. We don't have to, this is not time to depend on people's prayer. Everybody has to pray. There is nothing again like intercessor team. Everybody needs an intercessor. There's nothing like prayer band. Every Christian has been called to the ministry of prayer. All of us
must pray.
You must pray. Not only pray, please, you must pray the right things. What is the prayer? Thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. Thy kingdom come. Father, let your kingdom come in my family. Let my son be saved. Let my father be saved. That is the prayer God wants to hear. I'm telling you, the easiest way to attract the attention of heaven to your prayer is to pray for the salvation of souls. Heaven will hear you quickly because there is joy in heaven over a sinner that repents. So until we value the place of prayer, we cannot rise as the glorious church. So we must pray. You must pray. Be careful of too much distraction, too much of social media, and you're no longer praying. No, you have to go back. Discipline yourself. Put some things off. Give yourself time to pray. Give yourself to prayer. Force yourself to pray. Wake up in the night. Even if you wake up to urinate, take just 10 minutes and just pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, let your kingdom come. Because I'm telling you, you see, as I'm talking now like this, they are having their meetings everywhere. Why? It's not like before. We have entered the season. I told you that when this year began, we entered the beginning of the end. Did I tell you that? They are multiplying their agenda. And God said, okay, my people, pray. Pray. Pray in the morning. Pray in the night. Pray in the evening. Pray. David said, I pray 3 times, Psalms 55 and 17. 3 times a day he prayed. He lifted his voice 3 times to God. In the morning, in the afternoon, in the night. Pray. I'm telling you, your family, your life, it may depend on your prayer. I'm telling you, you have to pray. If you want that church to rise, let's give ourselves to prayer. Let's take away too much of entertainment in church and bring in more prayer. People are more comfortable being entertained than praying in church. He said, my house shall be called a house of prayer, which means that God is saying that the first way the world should identify the church is that that is a place of prayer. They know if you come to church, be ready to pray, because here we pray. We pray. If you check well, Christians don't like prayer meetings. They like meeting, man, it's okay. Can I prophesy? Yes, everybody see that. You start talking alone for 3 hours. I'm seeing. I'm talking as a prophet. You don't know the damage those things are doing. That even if you have to prophesy, let us first pray, even 1 or 2 hours. Let us pray first. Then we start prophesying. Let us pray first. Let's not make people come to church and sit down. Suddenly, I'm seeing. Those prophecies may not even come to pass. Not because they are fake, but because in the absence of prayer, prophecy has no power to produce divine manifestation. Satan will hold it. Have you not read that Daniel prayed, the prince of Persia arrested an angel of God. He resisted him for 21 days. That was prophecy being delayed. Daniel said, he discovered by the books that the time is passing for their captivity. Why? Because the devil does not, listen, Satan is wicked. If we don't pray, we shall be casualties in the hands of the devil. For the glorious church to rise, with the saints must give themselves to prayer. If you want to be part of the end time glorious church, you must be given to prayer. You must pray. Pray in the night. Pray in the morning. Pray in the afternoon. Don't just be holy. We don't want holy men who don't pray. Holy men should also pray. He said, let men lift up holy hands to God in prayer. So, we don't want people to be holy. I'm holy. Yes, be holy and pray. The anointing, the word, holiness, and prayer. Rise on your feet.